Our first speaker is Parker. Parker did a bid last year at the fall meeting. You guys all had an opportunity to bid and tell your story a little bit. So Parker's talk is going to be, well, I'll let him tell you what it's going to be about. But Parker's a local guy, Boise guy. He started a company a few years back, mentored by Brian Morgan. So Parker, tell us your story and enjoy.
All right, thanks, Jerry. Can you guys hear me all right? Good? Okay, cool. Thanks, everybody. The room's a lot fuller, more full than I thought it was going to be, so really stoked about that. Thanks for showing up. So we're in a room full of superintendents and assistants, some vendors. What are you guys doing to deal with thatch, drainage? What kind of management practices are we using? Chat them out.
Verticutting.
Verticutting?
Yeah.
We're using verticutting.
Aerify,
core aerify,
top dress,
cool, all physical management practices, right? So that's good. So we're going to talk about today reducing thatch and improving drainage infiltration using performance resource management, which is a biological management practice in essence. So what is PRM? PRM is a premium agronomic service that's designed to deliver superior results. So, what does that mean? We'll get into the details of that in a minute, and what our process really is. But first, you're probably wondering the existential question of the Cheshire Cat: who are you? I was born and raised in Boise. If you have dogs, my dad's a veterinarian. You might know him, Dr. Mike Cohn. Went to Centennial, graduated from Mountain View. College got confusing, studied mechanical engineering, got the degree from University of San Diego, did some neuroscience research for a little bit, and then 3 years of management consulting. Then I came up with the business model for performance resource management. So I also did the Great Lakes School of Turfgrass Science. Hats off to these guys, Dr. Koch, Sam Bauer, Dr. Brian Morgan, everybody involved. It's a super good program. I just want to acknowledge that we've got some guys taking it in the room. I know Ernesto's taking it. A few of you other guys are taking it, but it's $550. I think it's some of the best money you can spend on your guys. To put that in perspective, that's, what, 40 hours of your guys' time to have another set of eyes that's trained. To be out there, an extension of you, more education, big fan of these guys. They're doing a really good job. So I'm going to take a few slides from Dr. Doug Soldat's presentation on soils from the Great Lakes School of Turfgrass Science. This is one of Doug's most publicized quotes, I think, from the classes. We have too much emphasis on soil testing and not enough emphasis on compaction and drainage. So this is also, you know, quotes from his presentation. The biggest problems in turf: compaction, thatch, layering, organic matter, drainage. So let's talk about how we're going to address that with different management practices aside from, you know, purely physical. So here's your three properties of soil, right, directly from this slide. You got physical. What are our physical management practices? We're saying we're verticutting, we're core aerifying, we're top dressing. We're mowing. We're never going to stop mowing. We're never going to stop doing this stuff, right? Chemical. Fertilizing. Sustainable turf grass management. We need to fertilize. We got to do it. We got to spray. We got to spray fungicides in the fall. These upper elevation courses that get a lot of snow. We just got to do it to keep the turf alive. And then biological. So Dr. Soldat commented on biological. It's fairly new. Not a lot of us are doing a lot with biological, but, you know, another quote from his soils classes: the biological properties are the new frontier. We don't know a lot about the biological properties other than they appear to be very important. That's where performance resource management comes in. So we're taking a holistic approach to turf grass management, covering the biological properties of soil and the biological management practices that have largely been absent from turf grass management programs. How many of you guys are doing any biological stuff? One, two, three? I know Joe is, I know. So that's like what, 5% of the room, 10% of the room? So performance resource management takes a holistic approach to turf grass management to improve the turf quality, improve the playing conditions, and ultimately reduce the operating costs of running your golf course. So we'll start with our process, kind of what is PRM, where does it start, what do you do? So every one of my programs is designed specifically for my customer, specifically towards the site. I go out and I do an evaluation. I identify different measurable units. This is, you know, the academic side of, you know, I go to Joe, I say, hey Joe, I want to see your worst green, your best green, your average green. I want to see your worst fairway, your best fairway, your average fairway. Best tee, worst tee, average tee. I go out and take data from those areas. I look at infiltration, volumetric water content, compaction, soil profile, root depth, thatch layering, measure those with digital calipers, and turf density and quality. Here's what it looks like, part of the evaluation. This is just soil probes. So we're talking, you know, 100 to 120 soil probes each time I go out, measuring thatch layering, total depth, AO horizon here. We're also measuring infiltration with an infiltrometer, you know, volumetric water content, TDR. There's my digital calipers, here's some probes. This is me using the penetrometer on six fairway with Dr. Morgan here. And then some more photos of the evaluation. I calculated it, I spent over 90 hours at Hillcrest with this infiltrometer. There's a few data points that took, just for one data point, it took 3.5 hours to get with this. So that's what this third photo is here. That's me. The clock's at like 20 minutes or something right there. And it's not flush yet. So here's the process. As you know, on the whole, go out, do an evaluation, proposal and contract. First year we gotta do an install, you know, design the complete fertigation system and provide operation support and reporting, and then repeat the next year. But we don't have to do the install again, we just inspect. So we're gonna look at three sites with over 20 measurable units that we took in the year 2018, this last season. We ran some programs at River Birch, at Hillcrest, and Quail Hollow. And so what we're doing here is establishing a basis of empirical evidence. When I met Dr. Horgan like 2 years ago, he said one of the things he said to me was, you know, I'm your customer. You got to persuade me. You got to convince me. You got to go out and take the data that I take in my research and provide a scientific basis or argument for what you're doing and how it's improving the game of golf and golf management. So we'll look at River Birch first. These two photos were taken on July 21st, 2018. What I did, I went out there, I looked for the worst part of the first fairway. Clint gave me permission to go out and do some applications on one fairway. I identified this area, a lot of compaction, really dry, tons of thatch. I thought this was the worst area, so I called that the test, and then this little area over here, the control. So here's another couple photos, just another couple different perspectives to get a little more familiar with. This is the edge of the fairway on the west side. And so here's what it looked like after 6 weeks of application. So you can really see, you know, biology doesn't happen in lines. You've got two very defined lines here. Obvious turf quality, density improvements. Here's what the control looks like. So I took these probes are from this side of the line over here. We've got, I don't know if you can see, but at most maybe 2 inches. The roots aren't breaking through the thatch. That thatch creating a perched water table. You know, I think I had a conversation the other day with somebody, I think it was Tom. Fertilizing this doesn't do much because you're not getting it into the soil. The roots are hung up in the thatch. So what's it look like on the test side where it's obviously something's going on? Thatch is breaking down, you know, I'll take this, that's 3 inches of depth. The roots are, you know, driving maybe 2 inches into the soil there, up to maybe 6 over here. There's a close-up. So what's happening there is we're metabolizing the thatch, we're breaking it down into its principal components. We're increasing aerification, carbon cycling, getting into, you know, driving the water down, expanding the root zone. So, you guys a fan of numbers? We're gonna get into some numbers here, pretty much for the rest of the talk. So here's what compaction is. Compaction is kind of inverse. We've reduced, this is the control, this is the test. So it's inverse. The further we go down with the penetrometer, the less compaction there is. Here's infiltration, only got 2 data points. There was a slight improvement in the control where no PRM was used, 11%. He chlorified and top dressed this area, the one fairway. So I think we could attribute that improvement in the fall to that physical management practice. That was also done on my test plot. We didn't change. The only thing that was different was we were running PRM on that green square. And we had a 249% increase in infiltration. Pretty high, pretty significant. Here's probe depth. I'll skip through these real quick. We're reducing compaction. The probe's going down further. Roots are going down further. Water's going into the soil. Here we have, you know, root zone expansion. All these metrics are related to soil turf health, right? We got thatch reduction. This is pretty low, but I think there's a lot in this graph that we can learn from. The control actually increased in thatch over the course of the year on the control. So what's that mean? That means we're not managing thatch sustainably in this case, on this fairway. Like, it's gonna continue to grow and propagate. Where we ran PRM, we reduced the thatch by about 20%. And it's pretty crazy that 20% can provide, you know, 250% increase in infiltration. But all this stuff's related. Quick summary, you know, putting up good numbers, increase in quality, infiltration, thatch reduction, root zone expansion, expansion. Ultimately, the roots went into the dirt, which caused that difference. So next we'll go to Hillcrest. Hillcrest we ran on the entire course in the year 2018. We started in May, we ran through September. Joe, how many gallons did we run?
I think it was like 60,000.
Yeah, so we ran acre feet of product, of PRM on Hillcrest this last year. And we'll go through a couple results. Here we have thatch reduction. We're looking at the 2T. There was just too much data to show it all, so I gotta just take a snippet. But here we have spring, summer, and fall, 3 data points that we took. You know, we have significant thatch reduction, really consistent correlation, you know, throughout the soil profile. Percentage-wise, we're looking between 54 and 72% on, you know, throughout the layers on the second tee. So, root zone expansion. I wanted to show we've got a tee, we've got a fairway, we've got a green here. We've got root zone. The roots are driving deeper into the soil on each of these surfaces, anywhere from 20% to 163% on 9 fairway. So all this stuff goes into drainage, right? The infiltrometer, the 90 hours last summer. Here we have, you know, 10 tee, 6 green, 10 green, chipper, 9 fairway. We show consistent improvements in drainage across, you know, the course of the season. Anywhere from our worst here was 6 green, was 24% increase. Our best down here, this is that data point that took like 3.5 hours to get the first time. We improved the drainage from 3/100ths of an inch an hour to, in the fall, it was close to 9/10ths of an inch or 0.88 inches an hour. Huge percentage improvement. Are we done? No, we're going to keep monitoring the spot throughout the next season, but an inch an hour isn't very good still, right? We got to get that number up. Overall averages, 66% increase in root zone at Hillcrest, almost 300% increase in infiltration, and almost 50% thatch reduction. Here's just some, I broke it down into tees, greens, and fairways. Looking from course to course, we see very similar data coming from, you know, the greens at Quail to the greens at Hillcrest, the fairway at River Birch to the fairways at Hillcrest, to establish kind of an empirical argument that we're seeing correlations that are consistent from soil type to soil type, medium to medium, from golf course to golf course. So here's Quail. We ran on the greens this last year. Similar graphs, right? We're seeing drainage increase. 8 green was our worst. We only got a 40% increase in drainage, which I think we'd all be pretty happy with that. 2 green, huge, huge jump. 300% increase in infiltration. Probe depth, we're reducing compaction, driving the probe deeper into the soil profile. We're looking at 68 to 77% increase over the course of the season. Same story here with root zone and thatch. We're reducing thatch significantly and increasing the root zone. High level stats, we got, root zone increase in infiltration, and thatch reduction. So I averaged all the metrics from my course, from River Birch, from Quail Hollow, from Hillcrest, and here's kind of our 2018 summary of performance resource management in the valley. This is what we were able to do. Quantitatively, we increased root zone, increased infiltration, reduced thatch. The numbers are high. If you're getting 239% return on your investment portfolio with TD Ameritrade, you're killing it and you're in the wrong industry, right? Qualitatively, we saw increased density, increased resiliency, increased consistency, and overall increase in turf quality across all playing surfaces. I want to take a moment. I'm closing in. We got a few minutes for questions after this, but I really want to thank these guys. Couldn't be here without you. Dr. Brian Horgan, my mentor, huge. Sam Bauer, everyone at the Great Lakes Turf School. Dr. Koch, Lori Russell, thank you so much for being so welcoming and this whole community, the Idaho Golf Course Superintendent Association. You guys have been awesome and supportive. Joe Aholt, thanks for taking the risk last year. Thank you very much. Jared and Ernesto, you guys did a great job bringing data that I wasn't even looking at to my awareness. So thanks so much for that. Ben and Nick over at Quail, thanks guys. And Clint Travis for giving me the chance to work at River Birch. And then Rick Mooney, you're the man. I wouldn't have met any of these guys. I wouldn't be here if you hadn't said, I was hounding Rick, trying to get him to run PRM at Whitetail. And he's like, I don't got time to meet you. But if you make it to Coeur d'Alene, I will. So I made it up to Coeur d'Alene in 17. So thanks, Rick. Here's my contact info. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to engage Dr. Koch.
So what's the process here? So, how often are you making? So it looks like this is kind of an old, a more modern version of the old bugs in a jug. Right? So how often are you making applications? What's the process here?
So we're running on the entire irrigation system, right? That tank at Hillcrest is a pivot tank. It's a 1,600 gallon ag tank. We run every time the irrigation runs. We're running through every sprinkler head on the property. It's consistent. It's when do we want to stop? Well, it's when do we get, have we gotten thatch completely under control? Have we, the way I've designed the services, I'm going out and taking, you know, initial data sets. You know, 8 weeks in, we're tracking the progress and making sure we're delivering to our customers, you know, the numbers that we're showing on the board.
So this is microbial, right? These are biological injection into the system. So where do you source the bugs from, for lack of a better term?
Labs, essentially. So if you're a OMRI certified golf course, there's an OMRI product with an OMRI label. You just have to buy it from the lab. So all the product essentially consists of a food source and dehydrated microbacteria. So about 15 different strains, essential fungi. You guys are familiar with a lot of them. Bacillus, Azobacter, Actinomycetes, some fungi, mycorrhiza. There's quite a few different strains of Bacillus. So
you said Joe put out 60,000 gallons?
Yeah, 60 to 70.
So how many tank that you said that was a 1,600 gallon tank?
Yeah. Yeah, so
are you filling, you're getting the bugs in a dehydrated form and then you're filling it up with water and letting it activate?
Yeah, so it comes in powder. So the power of biology is really in replication and exponential growth. Are we good for a couple more minutes?
Yeah.
For a few more questions? Hillary, we're good for a couple more minutes. Dr. Cook said.
Okay.
We talked before.
I talked to Parker. Right.
I got permission. I got permission.
Well, once I saw Cook was up there, I'm like, oh, we're good. He's asking questions. He can take it out of his talk.
Cool. Yeah. No, so the power is really in the biology. So a gallon of powder, which is food source and dehydrated microbes. Once you put that product in the water, after about 3 hours, you get exponential growth. So every 15 minutes, you get a replication cycle. So in 2 hours, you've replicated 256 times.
Okay.
You know, that's huge.
Look, how about we let Parker wrap it up and keep Lori happy? And, you know, Parker's going to be around for lunch and everything?
Yeah.
So you guys try to feel free to tackle Parker, and I'm sure you can answer any questions on a one-on-one basis. So that was a good talk to you. Thanks.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Jerry.